Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, Pooja, last time what we talked was that self-esteem is an important thing. स्वाभिमान जिसको हम कहते हैं तो अब सेल्फ स्टीम जो गिर रहा है आज क्या नहीं है हमारे पास, लेकिन उसके बावजूद सेल्फ स्टीम नहीं है. सो इफ यू कुड जस्ट एलैबोरेट इन दिस एंड टेल अस दैट हाउ डू यू डिस्क्राइब सेल्फ स्टीम, व्हाट आर द स्टेप्स टू मेक योर सेल्फ स्ट्रॉन्गर एंड हाउ कैन द फैमिली ऑल्सो प्ले अ रोल.
Self-esteem is the way we feel, each of us feels within about ourselves. Mm-hmm. So how do I feel about myself? Do I think I'm incapable? Do mm-hmm. I think I'm ineffective? Sometimes teenage girls think I look so terrible. Mm-hmm. Teenage boys deal with their own issues. It's totally the way we feel about ourselves.
Okay.
And our interactions with others contribute to that greatly.
Mm-hmm.
There are ways that I can build my own self-esteem. But there is, my self-esteem is also affected by interactions that I have with other people.
Right.
So if I'm a teenager and I'm interacting with my parent, mm-hmm. my parent plays a huge role in how I perceive myself,
right.
how confident I feel, how equipped I feel to go out into the world, mm-hmm. how positive I feel.
Right.
So as let's talk first about parents,
yep.
and what role we can the parents can play.
Mm-hmm.
So our intent is to make our child feel good about themselves.
Right.
We want to create capable individuals,
mm-hmm.
leaders, essentially,
mm-hmm.
who would go out into the community, who would go out into the world when they are older and do wonderful things.
Right.
But for that, we need to interact with them in the right way.
Mm-hmm.
We contribute to the way they feel.
Right.
So if we are doing or interacting with them in a way that makes them feel less about themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, I'm comparing my child and I'm saying, see your friend, she always gets A grades, you never get A grades. Or I'm comparing my teenage son and I'm saying, you know, he always, your friend always get most valued player, you
mm-hmm.
never get it. These, without realizing, that's
right.
not any parent's intent.
Right.
But without realizing,
mm-hmm.
having these comparisons and talking to them
mm-hmm.
in that manner makes them feel, oh, I'm not good enough. Somebody
right.
is far better than I am,
mm-hmm.
right? And then there is also this, they feel that they have to do something specific to gain their parents' approval.
Mm-hmm.
So I want, my family is a family of doctors. I want my child to be a doctor. I think that is the most honorable profession and that's what I want for my child.
Right.
And then I try to keep saying, talking about that again and again, you know,
mm-hmm.
you've got to be a doctor, you've got to study hard, you've got to do this, you've got to go to this university,
mm-hmm.
you have to pick these courses, but maybe that's not what my child wants.
Mm-hmm.
He may want to be a painter, he may want to have his own business.
Right.
He may have different ideas about himself, but
mm-hmm.
now we are making, communicating that if you're not doing everything possible
mm-hmm.
to be a doctor, A, you're not good enough,
mm-hmm.
B, you don't have my approval, C, I don't appreciate you.
Right.
Right? So we are building these notions within
mm-hmm.
them that make them feel not so good about themselves.
Right.
And the fact is, as human beings, you and I included, we all want to be around people who make us feel good.
But today, again, in the society, what we are finding is that self-esteem is attached to materialistic things. And all the parents try to fulfill the, you know, needs of their children in whatever way or manner they can. But that branding things, a brand of, you know, everything needs to be met. Do you approve this? Because right now I find even many parents with small children just give them the best of the best things, and electronic gadgets are in the hands of 2 or 3 year old. And, you know, just that so that the children just remain busy with their own work.
Yes.
And as they grow up, their demands increase and their self-esteem also gets attached to those things. Because if they don't have this, somebody has it. So because he has it, I or she has to have it. So these kind of things, it becomes a vicious circle. So again, with your experience and while you were writing this book, what do you find? How to come out of this circle? Because it's a vicious circle now.
I think parents, first of all, need to change themselves
mm-hmm.
before they can give a perspective to their children.
Right.
I need to stop thinking that my child has to go to this university
mm-hmm.
and that's the best thing and that's what will look good to everybody.
Right.
It's whether it's a toy or whether it's the right university or the right school,
mm-hmm.
Trying to look at material things as a way of improving our image to the outside world,
right.
that focus needs to shift.
Mm-hmm.
And we all need to think about, we want to groom better human beings, we want to groom better leaders
right.
who go out into society and do wonderful things.
Mm-hmm.
And those leaders are not decided by which fancy toy they play
right.
with. In fact, what we are doing is, they move from, I see it at home too, it's a struggle, it's a
mm-hmm.
constant struggle, right? They move from the phone to the laptop,
right.
to the iPad, to the television.
Right.
It's endless.
Mm-hmm.
We're actually I feel they're going to stop thinking for themselves, right? Because there's so much outside onslaught, people constantly telling them, oh, this is good, that is good. They stop thinking for themselves and stop being true to themselves. And that's, as parents, we need to first change that before we can even communicate it to them, because more than what we speak, they observe us.
Absolutely. What else can the parents do apart from being the role models and also, as you said, to not to complain or criticize or just, you know, degenerate them for everything? Anything specific all, apart from what you have talked, the parents can do?
I think unconditional acceptance and total love is what will make the difference. And I'm not saying if your child is doing something wrong, you know,
don't reprimand the child.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying is sometimes when things, when they're doing something incorrect, we tend to attack them and not that specific behavior and issue. So suddenly bachcha kharab ho jata hai. Wo jo usne kiya hai ek kaam, wo theek hai, galat hai. But the child is not bad. So we have to address just that one issue and communicate with them on that particular issue, realizing that if they feel judged, the little communication that they are doing, wo bhi band ho jayega. They'll continue to do They'll continue to do whatever they have to. And now we won't, I mean, as it is, we don't know too much about it. It's only going to get worse because chup chup ke karenge, unko jo karna hai, wo karenge. And we've shut off the communication through our interactions with them.
Thank you very much. And next week, I would like to discuss with you, as today we have discussed about how the parents can play their role, especially the youth who are at risk, and what can they do or what they should do so that their self-esteem remains stronger. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.